Hello, my very dears. Welcome to your channel. This is Elsa from Oslo on October 2022. I'm very excited to tell you I made a new series for you who wants to be more familiar with the attractions in Oslo for tourists. This is my very first video in this series, and this belongs to Hanshaugen district, with the oldest standing building from 1100 and the oldest road from 1300. This district has an area of 3.6 square kilometers and 40,000 inhabitants in it. Yes, I will begin our video, and this is the first tourist attraction I want to show you. The street here is Damstredet. This is a narrow and crooked 160 meters long street with low, mostly wooden houses from 18th century. The interesting point is that these houses are preserved and inhabited. Okay, let me talk less and begin to show you this elegant Damstredet. Many tourists come to this street during the year to watch this elegant and historic street. And groups from schools, and especially artists. All these houses have their history, and it begins down the river from number 70 to up there number 1 as house number. A very unique perspective you will see in this street. In front of us, there is a great cemetery named our Savior Cemetery. That was created in 1808 on the Napoleon Wars, and it has been fooled and closed for new graves since 1952. This cemetery is the most famous one in Norway. Many famous Norwegians are buried here, as Edvard Munch, Henrik Ibsen, and Henrik Wieland. This is Akavayan, a part of the oldest road in Oslo from 1300. Our Savior Cemetery has an Orthodox church. And is in use now. This way is going to Gamle Aker Church, that is the oldest standing building in Oslo, and we will show it in another video for you. This very amazing place is the beginning of Damstredet, and that pink house is the first house who is number one. Henrik Wergeland lived here from 1839 to 1841. He was Norwegian poet and historian, a very famous one in Norway. This water area that you see as a mirror now was a fountain in a garden of one house here at the beginning of making this area. Thank you. this pink house. Number one is a kindergarten now, uses for children. Children plays inside this very unique building. Now we are going back into Damstredet, and we will look at the buildings a little bit more with details. On the left side, it was stable for horse of Henrik Wieland, and now it is a part of kindergarten. Here was the old garden before. This house is number 12. With a blue and dark yellow. Is a very characteristic colors. This is a very narrow alley with stairs who goes down to Fredensburg Wayen, there we were. We are the children. This is house number 40. That is from 1864. And it was a cafe in that time. This is Rabarbra House. We can wait. This was a shop before, and they made stuffs here. They used old stuffs to make new things. Rabarbra Slotte. This woman, Sigrun Berg, had textile shop here. And she was a designer and made job for many women in this district. She was here from 1962. And the boutique or shop salg was here from 1971 to 1991, 20 years. In the right side, we have this down alleys as very surprising one. I can show you this here. This down this street. House number 20. And this house, Damstredet number 7. It was a milk shop in 1835. In the right side, we have a secret way to the houses inside that area. This one is that alley we had seen from up. Hi, Kitty. Hi, baby. She lives here. Pushy, pushy. Is this your home? Look at the roses. Here is the secret way. Do you want to go first, Pussy? Go first. No? Okay. House number 32. So narrow is here. At the end, we can see the stairs. here. The very old one. And a cozy place in house number 28. And down here you can see the Fredensbogveien, there we started. Look at this one, so artistic. Puss, are you here? Puss, puss. No. You see the perspective. We have so many, many pictures and postal cards from this street. Students come here to drawing and painting. The houses in this street are expensive. Prices is from 100,000 crowns for 1 square meter. House number 9. I love this combination of green and dark rose, dark pink. Number 24. this one. People live here very happily. Architecture from old time in Oslo. And here, one of the most famous postal cards of Damstredet. House number 33 and house number 11 here. And look at that. Mostly young people are here. Oh, puss puss! Pussy! She feels very free. Okay, this was Damstredet. Now we are back in Fredensborg Wien, and I will show you two places that are famous here. And if you come here to visit this place, you can drink or eat in these two places. The first one is the popular bar Nectar here. And the, another one is the old French restaurant Chez Colin, with a traditional French kitchen. It smells butter here from the kitchen. There is a road back here. And of course a terrace to sit here and eat very traditional French food. Number 44. And now you are going inside this narrow road. Just amazing in October. Very, very old houses from 18th century. Farmen is the name of this blue, white, brown house. They are making this house number 60 as more new maybe. This was a part of Fredensburg. Okay, I just want to show you this again from here. This is the end of Fredensburg Wayen, and we are going inside the Marildas Wayen. Marildasveien and the way to Vulkan. Vulkan is an area in this district. I will show you all the Vulkan in one package in this series. But before we ending the Damstredet video, I will show you this one also. This is Kjærlighetsveien in Norwegian, or the path of love, the road of love. This walkway is from 1930. A very narrow way by the garden up to Telthusbakken. Kjærlighetsveien. And this is Marildasveien. Now I'm going to walk a little bit in the way of love. The lovers walked here in 1930 and up over until now. It's more beautiful when the lights become on after sunset. I can take a video after sunset another day from this path of love. Look at this. Whoa. The lovers eat there. It's amazing to walk here in this time of year. Just one time you visit Oslo, you will fall in love with this city. A very magical city. Here begins Parcel Garden. shy here to steal. The biggest parcel garden in Oslo. Here you can see the garden. Persons, families have their place. It can be 10 quadrat meters or more to plant your things. Up there is Telthusbakken, Gamle Aker, and the Gamle Aker Church. You can see from here the oldest building in Oslo. My next video in this series will be Telthusbakken and we will explore that amazing street. Oh, look at them. The sunflowers. This is Charlotte's Tin, the Way of Love, and I will tell bye-bye to you for today. Thank you for watching. Thank you for hearing me. Love you all and live life with love, most of all. Kiss you guys from Oslo, partial garden in Gammel Aker, Old Aker, and from Norway, Scandinavia, Europe, and our planet Earth. Keep safe and smile. Kisses. Bye-bye. See you in next video from this series.